Hi everyone, this is Chidi Talk. Okay, every Friday we share ideas on real estate, life, personal opportunity, personal development opportunity, and how you can take advantage of your own personal economy, build your own life, and maximize all the various opportunities that life deposits your way on a regular basis. Today, I'll have the opportunity to share with us on the power of social media and why social media isn't working for some people. There was a time, and I thought that social media was not working. And I told my friends or colleagues in the office that, you know what, I need to abandon social media. I think I need to focus on something else. Why? Because I was getting a lot of negative vibes from social media. Then I decided, okay, let me do the right thing. Let me do what is right. Let me do what is important. Let me focus on certain aspects. And you know what? I realized that because I wasn't following the right principle, or I wasn't following the right, I didn't have the right attitude towards social media. So it was killing me. And not helping me maximize all that I need to maximize. So quickly, why social media isn't working for you? Why social media isn't working for you? Five reasons social media isn't working for you. There are a lot of reasons. Some people will say 21 reasons. Some people will say even 50 reasons. Some people give you 1,000 reasons why social media isn't working for you. But today I'm going to be having that opportunity to share just five. Why social media isn't working for you, and why you what you need to do to get it right. So today on 2D Talk, we will be exploring why social media isn't working for you and how to make it work for you. So reason is this: we need to understand this before I even go into the discussion. We need to understand this: social media has come to stay. Social media has come to what? To stay. Social media now, a lot of people are becoming multi-millionaires from the social media platform, majorly because some people, maybe before now, you may not have heard about them before. Some people will still be roasting their bush rats in maybe in Ohafia, or probably maybe in Uturu and all of that. Some people will still be living in certain places, but because of the power of social media, they're able to connect with the world in general and able to build their own economy as a result of that. So how do you build your own personal economy? You must realize that social media has come to stay. And if you do not go with the flow, you will go at the flow. If you not understand how it works, you go with the torrent. And it is important that you understand the trend right now. Now, traditional media is dying gradually. We are seeing a painful exit of some of the major newspapers. Today, even before you read maybe your regular popular newspapers, you find a lot of it will have had a lot of effect on social media first. So you don't need to find out what the president of Nigeria is even saying was said 2 hours ago, or you don't need to wait till stay up to 10 p.m. in the middle of at night to determine whether the president has made a broadcast during the day. So today, the power of social media has given us opportunity for us, as this news is breaking, we are getting information. Information is now at our fingertips now, because people are making the information go viral. So we need to understand that social media has come to stay. We either go with the flow or you go out of flow. And it is important that you understand the force behind social media and how you can use social media to build your own personal economy. So why is social media not working for people? What are the five most important reasons why social media isn't working for you? Social media has worked for a lot of people. I dare to say this. For a lot of people, I know that I are already living testimonies of the power and the effect of social media. They understand today the power of social media is so powerful, it's so dynamic in such a way that social media has a great hold. including for us who are also in real estate, we find out that what we spend more on social media is even less now compared to what we spend on conventional media. Just imagine that if I have to go to run maybe a newspaper ad, a conventional newspaper ad, I'll probably spend about 500,000 to just be in the front page, or to be in the second or the third page of the newspaper. But with the power of social media, I don't even need 500,000 to get the same value, just get the same volume of people looking our way. So what I just need to just do is just maybe make some payment somewhere. Maybe less than 20,000, I'll probably get the same effect I will have on social media. And so that is one of the effects and the power that social media commands. So if we are not understanding this, we find out that we're burning energy. It is important, a lot of us, the problem is that we are not doing it right. The problem is that we are not doing it well. The problem is that we do not understand how it works. The problem is that we do not even understand or know, or we are ignorant of the processes that lead to that maximum success using the power of social media. So social media has come to say you cannot deny it. Social media is good, is great for your improvement in life. It's good for, it's a leverage. Social media is a leverage. Social media has come to say social media is a leverage. That means social media can get you to your destination faster. For example, I want to make a sale, If I want to make a sale, what social media does is that it increases or multiplies or increases the rate at which I'm going to make a sale. So for you, you need to understand that social media is a leverage. People who ordinarily not know you before or what you do will know, they will be able to engage you majorly because of the power of social media. So why are people not making, why is social media not working for some people? Why is social media not working? Why is it that some people are finding it difficult for them to be able to embrace social media? Some people are finding it very difficult for them to build so much success around their social media campaign. Why is it so difficult getting or building social media? Number one is this. First of all, you do not believe in social media. You don't believe in social media. You have probably a disbelief in social media. You have a disbelief towards social media. What do I mean that you have a disbelief towards social media? You like the idea of social media. You like the idea of social media, but you don't believe that social media has power to generate wealth. So, and that is where a lot of people, you have disbelief. If you have disbelief in something, probably you also have disregard for that thing. So you do not understand. You understand that okay, social media is there, but you don't believe that social media has capacity to build you the kind of wealth or income that you want to have. So what you are just doing is that they are just having fun on social media. So a lot of time, what people just want to do is that they feel that social media is just a place for social meeting. But you need to understand that social media is not just for social meeting. Social media is actually meant for maximum success. Social media is a business it's a platform for you to be able to build serious business and for you to make sales. Now, first of all, you see, you have this belief in social media. Number two is that you are not intentional about social media, because the reason why, if I'm going to ask us what do you use social media for? What is the purpose of social media to you? Now, the purpose of social media to Mr. A might be different from another person, might be different from your own perspective. The reason why you use social media is different from why Mr. A or Mr. B uses social media. So you need to be intentional. So what is my intention with social media? What is my intention? Is my intention to discuss the politics of Nigeria? Or is it to discuss the affairs of my past? Or is it to discuss relationships? Or is it to discuss marriages? Is it to discuss business? So if you understand what the intention is or what your intention should be, you find out that engaging in social media becomes so stressful. Like there are certain people, for those of us who are business minded in nature, who have focused towards business. The message of social media to us is for us to be able to build wealth. So you must understand that social media should be a platform. You must have an intention, and you need to be able to focus on that intention. So you must be intentional with social media. Be intentional. What do I want to achieve with social media? Do I want to build money? Do I want to create money with social media? Or do I just want to just entertain myself with social media? Now, because of the fact that a lot of people are not intentional, that is why they are always at the receiving end. So you must be intentional with social media. You must be intentional with social media. Now, there is a difference between being a consumer and being a producer. A consumer and a producer. A consumer is the person, a social media consumer is the person that he goes and scrolls. All he just does on social media is to scroll, or maybe on Facebook, for example, is to scroll from the beginning and keep on scrolling down. He's not satisfied. He refreshes again to get new content again. He keeps on scrolling down again and they repeat the process again. So you are either a consumer or you're a producer. Now, the content that a consumer consumes is produced by somebody who is a producer. Now, you must be intentional. Do I want to be a consumer or do I want to be a producer? So you must identify where you want to stand. You cannot stand on these two platforms. You must be intentional. Now, you find out that most people who are intentional about producing, they don't consume so much content on social media. That is why they have a life of their own. The ones who are the ones producing, they are not even addicted to social media. What they just only do social media for, because they know what, because the person who is this one, is this person that is addicted, this one, the consumer is the one who is addicted to social media. The social media is addicted to it. He's the one who is consuming all his whole activities is the bloodstream is filled with social media content, but he's unable to produce content. He's afraid of producing content. So you need to be able to say, you know what, I need to be able to be intentional with my social media approach. I will guideline, choose to be what? A producer, rather than becoming what? A consumer. So a consumer is somebody who you just have an account, and all you just do, sometimes you don't even like, you don't even post, you don't even do anything. All you just do on social media is to look at content that people will give to you. Now, the producer is the one who makes money from social media. The producer, why? Because he's pushing out something that people will consume. Because you need to think in terms of what do people want to hear, talk about. So I produce that content and I push it out. I produce that content and I push it out. And I push the content and I push it out. So for social media to work in your favor, you must do what? You must be able to push out content per time. You must be able to push out certain things per time that people are going to consume, that people will love. So you need to be able to identify that thing. Number two is that after being intentional, you must also, number three thing is that you must give people what they want. You are not giving people what they want. Not giving people what they want. You are not giving people what they want on social media. You are not giving people what they want on social media. So one of the reasons social media isn't working is that you are not giving people what they want. Now, you need to be able to give people what they want. You need to be able to give people what they want. What do people like to talk about? What do people like to hear about? What do people want to hear about? What do people want to hear about? What do people want to hear about? So you need to be able to identify what people want to hear. So give people what they want to hear. There is a starving market somewhere for you. You need to be able to know exactly what are people looking out for and what message do I want to pass. How do I push out my message to people? Now, one of the things that people want happiness on social media. That's why social media is much more about the social life aspect of people. That's what social media is about. Social media, people want to find out about money. People want to build relationship and to build network. People want to build wealth. People want peace of mind. People want happiness. And that's why you find out that the music, people want to be entertained. That's why you find out that comedians are doing a lot of skits, and a lot of them are rising by the day. That some comedians will charge some people want to run adverts on their various platforms as much as 600K. Why? Because they've been able to build their audience through the power of what? Of giving people what they want. So they've gotten to the point where people now, they become what you call an influencer. So you must be calm, you must always understand this. You need to give people what they want. What is it people are looking for? What is it that, if for example, I am a real estate person, for example, what is it about real estate that people are looking out for? People are looking out for making money. So what do I focus on? And one of the focus on is about the money aspect of social media. It's always money aspect of real estate. So people need to be able to identify what exactly people are looking out for, what exactly people will pay for, what exactly is it that people are in, that is in demand for, that other people are probably not doing. So you need, because you are not giving people what they want. That is why it seems that social media is not working for you. So you need to focus on that. Number one is that if first of all you have you don't even believe that social media will work. That's one. Number two is that you are not intentional with social media. You are not focusing on not being intentional. So you just like the idea of social media, you like to consume it, but you are not a producer. The third one is that you are not giving people what they want. Number four is that you are not consistent. Number four is that you are not consistent. People are not seeing you. No, people are not seeing you every day. You're not doing it every day. You're not doing it. And it's not just about doing it. It's about doing it as much as you can. It's not, let me tell you this, your social media account will not crash because you're pushing it. You're pushing so much content. You're not consistent. People see you today and the next time that they see your post is in the next 3 months or it's in the next 2 months. You're not being consistent. You're not consistent. So social media is not working for you because you're not consistent. Social media is not working for you because you are not out there. Because you are not out there, nobody knows you. It is the person who is consistent. Let me tell you this. Obscurity is the most expensive thing in the world. Obscurity is the most expensive thing in the world. So the person who is obscure, who is not known, who is in dark, nobody knows you. Nobody will die from you. The reason why social media isn't working for you is because you are not consistent. So they see you today, they don't see you tomorrow. So nobody, people can't trust you. The person who is not consistent should not be trusted. Cannot be trusted. It's not even worth trusting because you cannot depend your life on that individual because it's not consistent. That is the people, that's the way people on social media believe. So just guess what? Just leave social media for a while, or maybe 1 month or 2 months. You find out that the world will have moved on. The world will have moved on. The question is, are you consistent? The question is, are you consistent? You want social media to work for you. The question is, are you consistent? How consistent are you? What content are you bringing out on a daily basis? So you need to say, oh, you know, so somebody says, oh, when I do social media, I will be too overexposed. You already overexposed, my friend. You already overexposed. You have already overexposed yourself beyond. Let me tell you this. For those of you on Truecaller, you already overexposed. For those of you on Taxify, Google Map, and all of that, you already overexposed. People already know where the destinations are. So what are you hiding, my friend? So you're already overexposed. So be consistent. People need to see you. You're already overexposed. Don't say, I don't even want people to know me. You're already known. The moment you have an account, you're already known. Sometimes even some of us on our phones, your locations already switch on your location button. People already know you, my friend. So there's no need. What are you hiding for? You're already being overexposed. There's no crime for overexposure. There's no crime for doing too many adverts. Coca-Cola is doing adverts again and again. There's no crime for doing too many adverts. You already know Coca-Cola, but why is Coca-Cola still advertising? Because there's no crime for being overexposed, man. The only crime for being overexposed is when you just get it wrong. When you are being overexposed for negativity. But when you are overexposed for positivity, you keep on. People know that you are consistent. So you have an account. You have an account. Social media is meant to be an account. It's meant to be an account. That is why you call it Facebook account. You call it an Instagram account. What is it, the account? It's meant to become a platform for you to transact. An account is a platform that, an account is something that gives you a platform. It's a platform that gives you opportunity to do transactions. So your Instagram account is a platform to do what? To do a transaction. So you need to focus on being consistent. So you do it again and again. You do it again and again. So you push, even if you push content in the morning, push it in the afternoon, friend. So how consistent are you? See, let me tell you this. The world is hungry for information. The world is hungry for content. conquered never dies. That is why you find out that people like Tunde Edna, people still look forward to reading them again. People deliberately go to search, and they search and search and search because they're looking for content to consume. So what we are simply doing by pushing out content is that because we are pushing out content, we are building what we call a list of followers. And because, let me tell you this, it is the person who has followers that people will follow, that people will want to advertise on their various platforms. So you need to build, you need to be consistent. Consistency is what gives you followers. So what you need is followers. What you need is people to follow you. What you need is people to look in your direction. And consistency is what helps you to build that thing. So the reason why people aren't looking in your direction is because they are not consistent. You're not consistent. How many people have sent you even a friend request in the last three days? It's an indication that you are not even consistent. People don't know you. People are not following you. They've not heard about you. If you are, for example, a teacher, you are in your various field, you need to be consistent and start taking pictures of you teaching in the class. For example, take a picture of yourself this way and start teaching a class. Show people what you do for a living. If, for example, you are a stylist, do some hair, take some pictures, put yourself in those things, and at the end of the day, put yourself in such a way that you are sitting down in front of a head, you are making up a head, and you take a picture and you show it that this is this, and narrate what this kind of style does. This style is what people need. You know, do those things. Because when people are looking for something kind of this, they know where to go for help. So because we are consistent, because consistency is what makes you an expert. You are an expert not because you talk about a subject, but you are an expert because you talk about it again and again and again and again and again and again. So consistency is what makes you an expert. So people know you because, somebody gave birth to a child, maybe help a woman to give birth to a child, maybe in the house yesterday. Does that automatically make her a doctor? And you say, okay, because I see every woman who is pregnant, I go to them, I say, okay, you know what, because I delivered for a woman yesterday, so you know what, just come to my house, I will start delivering for all of you. Will you be able to trust that individual? It is by virtue of the person doing it consistently again and again that makes that individual an expert. So for you, the focus should be for you to becoming consistent so that you can also be an expert. Number five, why is social media not working? Number five is that you are not focused on the money side. You are not focused on the numbers. Not focusing on the numbers. Not focusing on the numbers. On the numbers. You are not focusing on the numbers. I'm not focusing on the numbers. Social media is about numbers. Social media is about people. Social media is about numbers. Now, social media is about numbers. How many people are on social media? 7 years ago, 10 years ago, was there, 10 years ago, was there, was, 10, okay, let us say, 20 years ago, was there Facebook? No. 15 years ago, was there WhatsApp? No. But some of these things have taken over a lot of people's lives. Because now it is the latest way for which people, you can get people to respond. To the extent that when you send a WhatsApp message to people, one of the first things you get to see is that you get to see whether the person has read that information or the information has been passed on to the person. Now you have first-time information as to what that person is reading, whether the person is reading it right now. You also, when the person is typing information, when the person is set to type something, you can see that indication that the person is typing. So what you are simply doing is that you need to focus on the numbers. So it leads you directly. So today you can speak to a celebrity chatting on your WhatsApp, which you will never have done before. So today somebody can be in worry and you take a picture and you're able to send that same picture to the person in worry. So social media helps you for leverage. But first of all, it also helps you for numbers. So you can commit to a large number of person at the same time. From the comfort of your bedroom, guess what, today, as I speak to you today, 200 and something people will watch this video, whether on Facebook or whether on Instagram or even on YouTube. At least 200 people will have access to this video. One of the things I know is that right now I'm doing this in the office, and probably we are less than 20 people right now in this office as I speak to you right now. As I speak to you, we are less than 20 people right now in this office. But guess what? Over 200 people are going to watch watch this video, when we push it and when we upload it. If I'm going to do that, I'm not going to pay any money just except for data, which is less than 1,000 naira, which is less than, even if it's less than 500 naira. Why? But literally, but 200 people are going to have access to that information. Why? Without actually paying so much for it. Just imagine we're going to produce this content and we're going to push it out on NTA this line. And we're going to push it on probably maybe on another popular platform. Now it helps me to be able to commit people and it's able to help me to build your own network. So because you're not focused on building a tribe, you're not focusing on building network. You're thinking that social media is just there. Social media is not just not there. Social media is an opportunity for you to be able to build in numbers. For you to build network. You need to build network. So the numbers need to make sense for you. Social media gives you the opportunity to reach out to people. So today, many people are running seminars on a regular basis, all from the comfort of the platform of social media. Some people are even getting paid. They are doing deliveries from social media, my friend, just because of the fact that some people are doing delivery. Some people are doing food business, and they are delivering stuff to people's homes, all because from social media. So you need to focus, without even having websites, some people are making serious money from social media. So you need to think in terms of the numbers. The numbers need to start making sense to you. The numbers of people on social media in Surulere, in Ijesha, in Lekki, in Aja, in Ikoyi, you need to start making sense for you. Let social media start making sense for you. The reason why a lot of people today are frustrated, the reason why a lot of people are not making as much money as they should from social media is majorly because they are not focusing on the numbers. So not focusing on the numbers will frustrate you. Not focusing on the numbers will give you, because the numbers is an opportunity for you. There are many, many people. You see, people are doing the same kind of business that they are doing. But guess what? Not you have your own crowd. You have your own numbers. Let that numbers make sense for you. I hope you've been able to learn one of those things. So there's power in social media. Don't give up on social media. Don't think that social media is worthless. Don't think that social media is unnecessary. Don't think that social media is not worth your time. Social media is worth your time. A lot of us who believe in our grades in school, university degrees and the like, social media is crapping a lot of things. Today, yes, some weeks back, I heard that some, maybe Google and, Google and some other companies that are well renowned, your university degree will not determine whether you apply for a job in their various companies anymore. Why? It is based, it's not going to be based on your creativity. And one of the things that social media does, because there is now a full world that you can, on your internet, you can have access to a lot of information that you want. And you can read history on social media. You can watch videos now on social media, on your YouTube channel, because I can buy YouTube as also social media. So you need to be able to explore. Stop thinking like old school person, like an old school person. Many people, many organizations today are paying other people to manage website for, you know, social media pages for them. All because of the fact that, because they are not beginning to serve them. But many, some years ago, a few years ago, maybe 2 years ago, 3 years ago, some of them believe that social media is not working. It shouldn't work. That, oh, what is social media? You remember the story where one of the former president of Nigeria called one of the bloggers and said, is that one a job? But today, that person is one of the richest, that lady today, in the KG, to be precise, is doing so well with social media, majorly because of the fact that social media has come to stay. And so you need to go with the flow, or you go out of flow. Don't behave like an old school person. You're not old school. Even today, people, somebody dies by virtue of social media. People are able to rally around the person. There's power in social media. Just imagine this lady, this little girl, the success story, for example, is the power of social media. Just imagine the life in less than how many hours, less than maybe a week or so, able to raise up on 5 million naira for this little girl. To just so that at least her life will change as a result of that. And some people are already inviting her to come. Why? Because somebody did a video and decided to post it on her page. And today that little girl, she's able to build popularity from that stuff. Guess what? If the people around her are helping her and know what to do, what the effect of social media, they will not just give it up immediately. What they will do is that they will build something around the little girl. I'm telling you, if I were them, I'll build something around that little girl. To be producing content on a regular basis with that girl. And guess what? The girl in future will be preserved. Number two, the people also around her, their future will also be preserved. Because it is something that you can take advantage of. But some people, That's how we are. But we need to understand the force that drives social media. I hope you have been able to learn one or two things. So five reasons why social media isn't working for you and how to make it work for yourself is what we have shared today on Truly Talk. And we still like come your way again next time. Every day, just stay rich, just stay free, just stay happy, live your dream and hustle like an immigrant.